Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we'll learn how to use the point light, spot light and distance lights in AutoCAD and gets its render view. So let's see. Now let's see how to apply different types of lights and get its render view. So I'll just go in AutoCAD. I'll just click on the start drawing. Now here I selected the AutoCAD 3D template. Now here we'll be creating some object and applying some material. I'll just select the box and draw one box here. Then suppose I want to create some different shapes as sphere. I'll draw one pyramid. Now I will apply some different materials. So for that, we'll just go in the visualize. Click here. I'll apply some material, but before that I have to apply material to the library. Now in fabric, suppose I'm selecting this velvet material, so I'll just click here to add to this library. Again we'll select flooring material. So I will select this and add to the library. Next we'll select the stone. Suppose I want this, so I'll just add this. I'll also select this and add this to the library. Now we'll apply this material to the objects. Suppose I add this red material to this wall. So like this it will appear, but actual appearance will be seen in the rendering. So I'll just apply the material first to the object, then we'll see the render views. Now here I will apply different materials, that is stone, to the different size of the box. For this I will just press Ctrl, select the face, click on the object to apply. See, like this we can apply the material on different faces. I'll just rotate this. I'll select this face. I'll apply different material. Is this? Again, I will apply the material on different side. So I'll just select this face and simultaneously this face. I'll select this material only. And on the bottom side, I'll select this material. Here we can see the purple material, but in red velvet we can't see, but the actual look we'll see in the render. And the pyramid will be using this floor carpet, so I'll just drag and drop on this object. See, now we'll see the actual render view. So by default in AutoCAD some kinds of lights are already applied to the material, that's why we can see this. So I will just go in the render view. I'll basically click this object here, click on the render to size, so it will create one render view of this object that we can see the actual level of lighting, and after that we'll see the different types of lights to add. So basically it will take some time to create the render. Okay, that is creating the render view of the object. So the actual look and appearance of the material will be seen here after the render view. See, so I'll just keep this material to the center. See, now again we'll see the render view. See, so the actual render view will be created like this. You can zoom this. See, now let's see the appearance, the addition of different lights. So I'll just move this ball to some distance. Now we'll add light here. So for adding light, you have to go here and click on here. So first we'll see the point. So here basically it is asking whether to turn off the default lighting. So it is indicating that already some kind of lighting was applied. So I'll just keep the default lighting turned on only, and I will add the additional light. Suppose I want to add the additional light here. Now here there are different properties of the lights, that is name, intensity factor, status, numeric, shadow, tension, filter color. Suppose I am going the intensity factor. I'll just take the intensity factor to say as 2 for now. Press enter. I'll just make it to 2D wireframe. We'll just make the positioning of the light properly. From the top it is proper. I'll just go in the front view. I'll just basically move this ball. I'll just move this light some upper direction. Place it here. Now we'll see the render. I'll just again go in the realistic view. Now I'll click on the render to size. See, now you can see the effect of the light only on this face. So like this, you can use the point light to give the light on specific point or area. Now suppose I will increase the properties, that is the intensity factor. So just click on the properties. Just click on the light. I can just go on the light. I'll just make it to 2D wireframe for now. So to change the properties, I'll just go in the customize and add the properties of the lights. See, from here we can add the properties that we want. Suppose the lamp intensity, intensity factor, all of angle, on off status, and the positioning. For now we'll add on this property only. Click on apply and click OK. I will be getting the properties of the light. I'll just click here. Basically the lamp intensity here it is 1500. And here it is showing the 1500 CD. CD means candela. And so we'll be getting different types of units. So first it's of candela, second is flux, that is the lumen, and third it is of the lux. So like this we can get the different intensity and type and the factor. Or suppose I'll just increase the intensity factor to say 6 and click OK. Now we'll see the render. Again I will just go in the visualize. We'll click the render to size. See, now it is glowing more than the earlier. See, like this if we increase the factor it will just glow. And suppose we change the type value, that is this lamp intensity. Let's see what the effect will be created. I'll increase to 2500. Again I will click on the render to size. See, now it is growing more than earlier. Now we'll add some different lights. So now we'll add the spotlight. I'll keep the default lighting on only. I will add the light to this face, because here from point light we can see this face, but we can't see this side face. So I'll just keep it here for now. I will change the direction to here. We'll increase the intensity factor to say 10. We just go in the side view. I'll just move this pyramid. There is circle also. That is the sphere. See. From here, basically the positioning is not proper. So I'll have to rotate this. Before that, we'll just go in the top view and we'll check view accordingly. Basically, I'll just first move this light. I select this base point and move this here. I will use the rotate option, rotate this light. I just rotate it to 90 degree. I will shift the view. I want to increase this size. I can increase the size by changing the arrows. See, like this, I can increase the circle of this spotlight. I'll just move it to upward direction. Now basically it is focusing somewhere on this face. So let's see the render. I'll just go in the realistic again. I'll just click on the render to size. Again, it is just showing me the upper view. That means our light has been not properly placed. So I'll just again go in the 2D wireframe. We'll just position this light properly. So from this it is proper. Again, I'll go in the front view. I'll just take it more closer to the object. I'll just increase the size. I'll delete this point light. Now we'll see the effect. So again, we'll go in the realistic view, click on the render to size. See, now it is showing me the proper spotlight which I have given. It is showing me the object, the given material. Suppose I want to see the whole object, so I will have to increase this circle size. I'll increase the intensity factor to say 20. Again, we'll click on the render to size. See, now it is glowing more than the earlier. So like this, we can use the spotlight to give the light and the specific direction. Now we'll see how to give the distance light. So basically, we'll apply this on this pyramid. So first we'll see the normal render of this pyramid. Basically, it is not showing any view. Admin light is not properly applied here. If you want, suppose ground shadows, you can just click here to get the shadows. I'll just go here and click on the distance light. We'll keep the turn off default lighting. Again, we'll go in the distance light. We'll allow distance light. We'll specify the direction from which side we want the light. We can increase the intensity factor. So I will take the intensity factor as 15. Now just tilt this. Click on the render to size. Now we'll see whether it is showing me. See, now it is showing me the side from which I have added the distant light, and from here it is showing me the spotlight which I have given, that is this light. Like this, I get the render. Suppose I want to increase, you can increase more further the intensity factor. And suppose I want to add the distant light from other direction, I'll allow this and add from this direction. I'll make the ortho command off. Go in the intensity factor, I'll take the factor as 25. We'll again go in the render to size view. See, now it is showing the proper pyramid glow. So like this, we can use the light to give the light and effects in any direction or any corner of the object. If you want full shadow, just click here. You can just go in the render to size. So here basically the shadow has been not showing, because we are in the normal view, we are not applied any environment. If we suppose apply the environment, then we will be getting the shadows. Like this, we can use the point light, spotlight and the distance light on the object. And from here also, we can change the view, or we can select from here. Thank you friends for watching this video.